Hello there, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome back to Shaun Builds a Blank. And today, we are going to build a fourth dimension roller coaster without rotations. Because I'm not going to do the rotations because they are very, very complicated and cumbersome. And I might actually end up doing the rotations, but not in this part. And if I do the rotations, it's not going to be like the next part's going to be like how to do the rotations, because I'm going to do all of those rotations off screen because I'm probably going to get really, really annoyed with them, and you guys don't need to see that. And I'm sure that you guys would enjoy it because you're all terrible people, but that's not my fault. But anyways, so starting out, most fourth dimension coasters are, sorry, I take that back. I think that the only two out of three, Eejanaika and X2 both have seven car trains. I'm pretty sure they have seven car trains. It might be six, and then I know that the one in China, I don't remember what the name, it's called like China Flying Dinosaur or something weird like that. But I don't remember. But anyways, you want to start them out with this kind of gradual drop out of the station. And then you kind of want to have a sweeping turn. And in this case, I'm going to have it angle this way and then go up over the station, because that's what X does. And I'm kind of basing them off of X. And you may have noticed that there is some terrain over there. And I'm hoping that I can use that to do something interesting with. And that right there seems fine. I'm going to add a very, very small friction brake section. It's actually no, I'm going to do drive tires. Let's see if that right there is straight. I'm going to add a catwalk to it. I'm actually going to have a catwalk along this whole thing. So I should probably do that really, really quick before I forget. Because X has a catwalk along the whole thing. And seat rotation, yeah, I'm not going to bother with that right now. Now, let's start with the lift hill, because that's how roller coasters start. And that right there should be a pretty good angle of ascent. Now, I think X is about 180 feet tall with the terrain playing in. Into it. I think it ends up being about like 205 feet or somewhere along there. So I'm going to go ahead and cap right now because that's at 189. And alright, this should be interesting right here. So you see how there's that terrain right there? I'm going to play into that a little bit. But first of all, you want to have a little tiny pre-drop. Actually, they're not really that tiny. They're actually kind of big as far as pre-drops go. And then you want to have it go up. And then straight down. And I don't want to have it go underground because I think that would be kind of weird. So I'm going to go ahead and start bringing it up. No, you can just auto tunnel, and that's fine. Okay, and I need to fix that. Actually, no, because that drop right there is fine. No, stop. I don't want you to turn. That is the opposite of what I want you to do. Okay, and is that straight? Yes. Alright, so I did kind of trench it out a little bit, and I didn't really want to have to trench it out, but oh well. So now I'm going to have it gradually start coming up, and we're going to go into a very, very signature element on these rides, and that would be a Raven Turn. Now, Raven Turns are used mainly to reverse the direction of the ride. I actually did have it start going out a little bit more. More like there, and then have it going like that, but I also need you to go that way. Probably actually a bit easier if I got it like that, and got it like that. Okay, and I actually should probably test that because that looks like it might be really, really close. I'm not sure if it should. I think it should clear it, but I'm not really that 100% confident. All right, it very slowly made it through there. I might raise the dispatch speed slightly. Dispatch speed, actually 9's fine. I know, it really doesn't need to be going any faster than that. No, I think the best way for them to do rotations were to, like, actually give you, like, a diagram of the seat instead of having it be the thing where you click on it and then you go to utility and you change the seat angle to X degree. So it gets really, really confusing, and that's why I think most people don't like building these styles of roller coasters. It's just because they're really, really, a pain in the ass to build. And that right there is where the seats would rotate. And let's see. Yeah, it just makes it, and that's fine. So I don't really want it going ridiculously fast. No, I actually want to bring the steepness of that down. And okay, let's have you straighten out. And I'm, yeah, good, it's not turning. I didn't want to turn any more than that. Okay, that seems good. Now that that's done, I'm gonna go ahead and start smoothing that, and hopefully it doesn't mess with it too much. Now, this is an aero coaster, and they are not known for being smooth, so this is not going to be a butter smooth ride, especially once I do the rotations at some point. Not right now, or even the next part. You guys are going to have to be really, really patient if you want me to do this properly. And yeah, pull up the train really quick. Now, I'm hoping that this doesn't mess with this hump too much. Yeah, that still looks fine, and that Raven turn still looks fine, although it's definitely a lot higher up than it should be right there. But oh well, not much I can really do about that. I could bank this slightly, but I don't think it's exactly necessary. Now, the next element that I'm going to add here is going to be what looks like an air hill. But it won't actually be one, because in reality there would be a seat rotation here, but since actually, well, it's already at 118, you can start capping out there, and then go down. And now I'm going to do something way different. Normally at this point there would be a turn but I am not going to add a turn just yet. I am going to add what is called a half-half. It's a turn that's basically meant to rotate the train to a different direction. And normally they happen like right before a, another Raven turn. But in this case, I'm not going to do that. So that right there is fine. Actually, is that? So 45. Like that, and then like that. Really curious to see what the speed is like for this element. Problem that we have right here is that we are getting really, really close to Expedition Millennium Force. Let's start the turn now. I'm gonna get real, real close to it. Like almost a scary close. This direction. I'm gonna go up and then I'm gonna have to go back down. Let's see. Yeah, that right there looks good. I'll obviously smooth it out at some point. I'm gonna bring that down slightly. I'm already going like way off the beaten path with this than what a normal 4D coaster would do. It's kind of fun taking the liberty sometimes. And that's already telling me that it's obstructed, which means it's too close to that. I think that might not be banked enough. We'll see. I'm not really shooting for ratings right now. Actually, no. I'm gonna redo this turn slightly. And by slightly, I mean I'm gonna completely redo it. Okay. Now, this is something that none of them have really done, but I'm gonna do it anyways. I'm actually gonna turn this into a half-half into a, an inside Raven turn. Now, I hate this element. I don't think it's very fun. It's my least favorite part of X2. It's, notoriously rough, and I would not recommend it to anybody. That seems good. And as you can tell, we are once again inverted. And it's still turning. Stop that. Okay. So there's that. Now it's going to go. Smooth out that. And that's already kind of ruining the shaping of this turn. Yikes, that right there is very, very ugly. I do not like that. Do this. I'm gonna bring it up more. Just so that when I smooth it, it doesn't lose a lot of its shape. Train is going through the inside Raven Turn. Now it's going into the air hill. Now it's going into this weird thing. And down it goes. Now I think that I should be able to kind of improve on that. I actually want this going this section. Whoa, not that much. This section. Okay. Not sure if that really helped. This is something that I wish that Arrow would have done a long time ago on this element. I'm gonna add trim brakes right there because sometimes it just goes too fast. So I'm gonna set that to like 38. Because if the ride ends up not having enough speed, then I can just get rid of it. Oh, excuse me. I feel like it's a tradition for me to burp in a video when I'm recording it. Wasn't intentional, by the way, it just kind of happened. So now I'm going to go with the full element, which is basically just a 0g roll, but it's on a 4d coaster, so therefore it's different, and the feeling that you would experience would be different due to seat rotation. Now I do want to start bringing the ride to an end, so once I smooth out this section, I'm going to build the block section and the final brakes. That rotation right there, or I guess inversion rather, actually looked really, really nice. Okay, click that. Section with an optional catwalk. It should be called a mandatory catwalk. Let's see, right there, and then there's a bunch of drivers. Actually, no. Drive turn, friction brakes. Drive turn, friction brakes. Friction brake. Now, if this were, like a real life right here, I would actually add an unload station, or rather right here I would add an unload station, but there aren't any, so I'm not going to add an unload station. Now that right there is going to be another block, and then we're just going to put friction brakes right here. Man, I can't talk right now. This is quite embarrassing. Now I'm going to add one more tiny piece. Then right here, get rid of that. I'm just going to have it very, very gently glide into the station. Okay, now start smoothing that and that. Okay. I might have to redo this part. Actually, I think it would be cooler if I had it gliding along that rock work. So, let's go for that instead. Now, actually, I wonder if I can get it to, let's see, if I go like that. Add something like that in there. I'm gonna bring it out a tiny, tiny bit. And you're just gonna hug that right there, and I'm gonna turn off auto tunnel. So I just want it to get real, real close to that. Okay. What happens if I do autocomplete? It does that, which I don't like because there's no character to it. That's why I don't ever use autocomplete, because it ends up just looking dumb. Except for right now. Oh. Why? Why would that be the thing to build? Just think about that for a second, game. I will do something similar to that, but not quite. I'm going to add another small air hill. And now I'm going to get rid of this section. So we just have it going along right there. Okay. That right there actually looks fine. And let's start smoothy, smoothy, smooth. Smooth, smooth, smooth. Smooth, smooth, smooth. There we go. There's not enough smoothing going on right now. Blow up that train because I didn't like those dummies on there. Okay. Alright, there we go. And let's start smoothing out this section because it needs some smoothing. Okay. Hit that right there. And I should probably actually have it going the opposite direction. just looks really, really cool, so I'm not. Really, really need to work this into some proper inversions slash banking slash rotations, whatever you want to call it. And then it's just gonna go right into those brakes. Definitely made it. Okay, and I need to add actual brakes to that. Target speed is gonna be 20, 12. Yeah, that's the block section right there. Then this section right here, it's going to be set to 11. That. And fast, 8, 11, 8, and that one's fine because it doesn't matter. But I will have that set higher. Sure why it was fighting me right there. Set that higher. Okay. Now, really quickly, I'm going to go ahead and set this to block section with two trains. It could run three, but it doesn't need to. And the color scheme, I'm going to go ahead and change it back to OGX colors because I actually really like that color scheme. I know a lot of people didn't, but I'm one of those that did. So, okay. That right there, I believe it was yellow, though it was more yellow than that. Go into the color thing and yellow. That's yellow right there. Alright, track color. It was like that, I think. No, it was way brighter than that. No. Can I not make it the right color? Or is it just because it's highlighted? Or because that right there looks like gray or blue. That's not what color I want. I want, like, pink. That'll, you know what? That'll do. And then this part right here is going to be yellow. Actually, no, that part right there is also that, I think. And then that part's yellow. Does it look right? Yeah, that actually does look right. I think that maybe one of the rails was the purple also. But, oh well. And the trains were... Actually, I'm not going to mess with the trains. It's fine. Okay. Let's go on this. And front bumper's fine for right now, I guess. Although it's a... actually not accurate. Wait. Does this thing play music? No. No music. And stop. I don't know why it was playing music. I guess just because X2 does. It was like, oh, I have to have music also. Very, very crisp, 93 FPS right now, by the way. Boy, do I love it. I removed the guest cap to Cedar Fair Park, and now it's getting a 3 FPS, so I'm going to give you one part of really, really crappy stuff so that you guys can be like, look at how many people are in the queues, and then I'm getting rid of everyone again because I need to be able to play the game. Alright, here we go. We are at the top. Operations are really, really nice for that. And what are the ratings? 587-416-416. Not too bad. Now, let's see if I can actually get a rotation accurate on this. Let me move way over here. So, let's see. I just want this section and seat rotation. Oh, hey, look, it actually does. So at zero, it's like that. And then I want it to go. Like that. And then. There. And then here, I want you to be on your back, I think. Alright, let's watch this. Let's see if I'm actually getting this right. Where is it rotating? Because I didn't tell it to rotate anywhere on the lift. Did I? Just stay at zero. Yeah, just. Okay, that was weird. Okay. Now, hopefully, that fixed that odd problem that was messing up everything. Stuck in my throat. Oh no. Alright. So it's coming up here. And I could actually rotate the seats back just slightly. Now let's see if I have these seats going the right way. Let's see. That didn't seem right. Okay, this is just confusing. Alright, seat rotation 120, which is that. Okay. Now, that part's fine. Not doing anything that I actually wanted to do right now, and this is why I know you stay normal. No. Okay, maybe if I just okay. This is why I don't bother with the seat rotations. Oh my god. Yeah, that's good. Yeah, like that. Just stay like that. And then I'm gonna click on this one. It's like, oh, well, I thought that was what you wanted. No, it wasn't. It was not what I wanted. And you right there, you should just be straight. Just don't do anything. Oh my god. I just want to get the rotations on the drop right. And okay. And no. You know what? We're just gonna give up right now. The POV of it was fine. And that showed you how good this ride is. So thank you very much for watching. Next week we're going to build something different, and I'm not going to bother with the rotations on screen. Next week, as suggested, well, confusingly suggested, after I built this, people wanted me to build a bunch of different things. One person was like, build a T-Rex coaster, but I pointed out that there's no actual T-Rex coaster, so anything that we build is all speculation, so like, I could build what I think one of these would be, but I don't know if it's accurate, and I'm kind of going for realism with this series, so not doing that. One person did say 4D coaster, and that I was up to the challenge, so I built that. The same person said T-Rex said just do a floorless instead, but I probably will at some point, just not yet. Another said that there's launch coasters with inversions that are a lot longer than that, and yes, you are correct, there are launched coasters that are longer than this, but all the intimate accelerator coasters, as in ones that have the hydraulic launch system, they're all very, very short, mostly because they can't rely on multiple launches, because they have to set up with the catch car for them to launch, so normally they just want to use most of their speed up relatively early on and end with a bunch of speed also. Now, Maverick is an example of a Intamin Blitz coaster, and yes, those do have a lot of speed through. I think Intamin Blitz coasters would be I-Speed, Maverick, I think there's a few more. And they don't have the actual model in here, but I could do it with the Premier style coaster, which is why I never find it. It's right here. But I would have to make the trains, probably two car trains. Because these are longer trains. They have a three row cars. So normally the rotations that they can do aren't as compact as that you would find on a trailer train. Now, let's get even more nerdy. Trailered trains are ones like this. So you have the front carriage right here that actually technically that's a zero car because it's its own set of wheels attached to the nose. but it's not part of car 1, so therefore it's car 0. Car 1 has that wheel assembly, and that one connects up to car 2's wheel assembly, and so on and so forth. And then you have ones like the launch torque coaster that... Let me zoom underneath. Alright. Now, as you can see with this, each car has its own set of wheels. So, car 1 has 2 wheel assemblies on each side of it, and thus their flexibility isn't as good, and they can't do as tight of elements that you would find on most Intamin Blitz coasters. So, yep, there's your little nerdy lesson for today. Now, Intamin 4D coasters, those are also trailered, and that's pretty obvious. Anyways, that's enough of that. I kind of went off on a tangent. Do you guys want me to do, like, a roller coaster nerd lesson thing? Because I'm totally down to do that if you guys want me to, so let me know in the comments, and let me know what you want me to build. I think I might do either a Premier Spaghetti Bowl, like the proper Flight of Fear style recreation, because someone did want me to do that, or I might build a Gerstlauer Eurofighter, which would be... Let me click on the right one. It would be... This one right here, and it has vertical lift hills and inversions. It's kind of like the Smiler and SpongeBob's Rock Bottom Plunge at Universe. Yeah, anyways, thank you very much for watching. I'll see you next time.